Hello again, everyone. Today, we will show you a short video about how the IB series perimeter beam with a charger and wireless connection to the alarm host works. You should already have a pair of beam or perimeter sensors, of which you should connect each one to the electricity with a 12-volt charger. The connection with the alarm host will be made wirelessly, that is, without cables. The detector beam will be activated if both imaginary lines connecting both sides are broken. Let's see a practical example about how the perimeter sensor's beam works. You'll need a power adapter connected to each side beam. Each perimeter sensor is different because one is the receiver of the infrared signal and sender with the host, and another is the sender of the infrared signal. Open up one beam in this way to see the components inside. You can see this part of the detector, the tamper button, positive and negative 12-volt power connections to the charger. Open the rest of the detector to see other parts, like these jumpers, and will allow you to adjust the detection sensitivity. This side of the barrier has two LEDs at the bottom and another two at the top. Insert the plate into the housing through the guide. To connect each barrier, check how the AC-DC connections are different, so it cannot be connected directly. Use scissors to cut the end of the cable and access its inside. Help yourself with a cable stripper to make it easier. Strip the wires to the size you need. Prepare both cables to be inserted into the terminal strip connections. Using a small screwdriver, secure both wires to the strip. Connect the red cable to the positive and black to the negative. We have had a small failure, and that is that before connecting the cable, we should have passed the cable through the upper plug, since now we cannot pass it. When we connect to the other side of the barrier, you will see it clearer. If you have connected everything correctly, when you plug in the charger, it will light up like this. We have already connected one side of the barrier, and the other side we've done in the same way. Connecting the positive with the red cable and negative with the black. We're going to match both sides of the beams and connect them to the electricity. If the barrier is completely broken, the alarm will be activated. If If only one part of the beam is broken, it will not be activated. It will only be activated when completely broken. When this sound occurs, the beam will send a wireless signal to the alarm host. We're going to remove the cables and show you how to close the barrier, since the first time it usually takes a little work. This part is closed, so to pass the cable you will have to make a small hole. Place the cap in this position and tighten, although it usually takes a bit of work. Our suggestion is that you remove the upper protective plastic to open the barrier housing a little. Thus, you can easily insert the cap and place the protector later. Perfect! You have it ready to go! With this, we say goodbye, but not without first asking you to leave us a like on the video and subscribe to the channel to follow us on YouTube for more of this type of video.